kasama yung Philippine Commission on Human Rights. Basta marami kami, DFA, ang mahalaga na nakasama namin doon was the Department of Foreign Affairs because the Geneva Post was the one that helped us. The UN Permanent Representative of ours, Ambassador Ivan Garcia helped us a lot, and their team in Geneva. Makikita mo rito that the Philippine delegation as a team in action, which delegation I headed in Geneva during those days. Yes, anti-terror law was mentioned, and that we clarified the issues with the anti-terror law because there were many misgivings being rooted about by civil society organizations on the abuse of the anti-terror law. And I clarified it already to them that the anti-terror law was crafted to comply with international standards, and that there are countries which have stricter, which give more power to the state with regards to the enforcement of provisions of the anti-terror law. For example, Singapore, which gives a 720-day period of detention, and then other countries which give longer periods of detention.
Indonesia.
Indonesia, Singapore,
Bangladesh.
There's also Western countries, many Western countries that adhere to the principles of the anti-terror mechanisms necessary to keep their state secure.
Sir, ano yung pagtanggap ng international community after our defense doon sa anti-terror?
I think it was very well received. When we clarified to them that these issues were addressed properly and that we have a 24-day, 14 days and extendable by another 10 days period vis-a-vis the other countries which have longer periods, we explained to them these intricacies which actually protect more rights than most other comparative laws that have been passed throughout the world, and that we really took great pains in crafting this law, and I think that I was part of that. I was part of the Congress that passed the law, the anti-terror law of 2020.
Yes. You mentioned 9 orders nagmula sa loob ng Pilipinas. Kung pumatrata daw galing sa Pilipinas, what are you going to do about
it? We'll find out sino. Basta nalaman natin kung sino, we will protect the witness to the fullest possible extent. Kasi, ano yan, malalim yan. I actually have no knowledge yet, no? Na kanya sinasabi. I want to be briefed about it. And I will ask Secretary Abalos to brief me later. Sa loob ng Bilibid, kung sino man yan, dapat malaman natin. Ilalabas natin yan.
Oh. In order to kayo kay DG
To DG Bantag?
Yes, sir.
Ngayon ko lang nalaman yan eh. I just found out now. I will immediately after this meeting, I will tell him to give me a report on this if he has any knowledge already. Because what the gunman said and what the DG knows, we do not know if they are the same. We cannot presume that. I haven't talked to him actually since the beginning. I've stayed away from the case. I have not talked to anybody. I have not asked anybody any favor. I just talked to a cousin of mine who's a lawyer who will start or has started representing him already. That's all that's everything that I have to do with the case. I have nothing else to do with the case. No, I no comment. I will not comment on that. That's something to do with the case already. I will not comment. It will not happen. I will not comment anymore on the other issues there. But it will not happen. That is not my call. I am a very honorable person when it comes to this. It's the president's call. And if I feel later on that I am not any more effective in this position, then I will talk to the president about whatever has to be done in the future. Yes, the moment I arrived, I called him immediately when I landed, and I spoke to him.
Ano pong napag-usapan, if you could share with us?
Well, he just said that he commiserates with my plight as a parent. That's all. And he said that just go back to work because we need you. Sabi niya, we have to start working again in the local scene since you were able to do well in the international scene. We need you again in the local scene to do what has to be done.
To continue
what we've been doing, what we started doing to reform the justice system. No, I don't. Anyway, no comment. Pero I think I'm calm enough to face anybody about any issue, and if I cannot be baited into discussing things which do not need discussing from me, because since I have said I've recused myself from the very beginning. No comment on that. We have to know. The charges have to be filed. The conviction has to ensue.
You vet your testimony.
If it's going to be a plea of guilty, it has to be vetted properly. The testimony has to come out so that there will be a basis for the police to act on this matter later on. Because that definitely a gunman is not the whole crime itself. It has to be vetted as a whole conspiracy, probably. Nobody, no gunman will be there without a conspiracy.
Sir, sorry, pasensya na, sir. Balikan ko lang po yung sa anak po ninyo. Nag-report po ba sa inyo, sir, yung prosecutor general to sa sitwasyon?
I have nothing to do with that. He has nothing. He will not talk to me about it. I will not talk to him about it.
Sir, pasensya din po. How is the family? How are you?
We're holding up very well. My wife, my mother, my children, my brothers and sisters are all supportive. And I'd like to thank those people who have sent me statements of support on text, Viber text, and all messaging platforms. No? I appreciate the statements of support. I appreciate the support given to me by the DOJ. And the fact that when this thing happened, people were worried, and we just said, we just go back to work because this will not change the flow of work that we have to do. Because the deadline, as I said yesterday in the flag raising, the deadline for things we have to do in the DOJ is yesterday. We have to really rush to work and finish these reforms that have to be laid out to make our justice system better. Prosecution system, correction system, investigative system, our system pardon and parole, parole and probation. All of these matters that have to be threshed out. Our land registration, our immigration, things that the DOJ is on top of and has to be on top of to be able to guide these agencies which actually affect our quality of life as a country. The first deportations will happen October 19. I have been briefed by the immigration commissioner. 5 or 6 of them will be deported. Self-deportation muna to that they're paying for. There are 400 more in custody which are being scheduled. China is validating the identities of the persons to be deported if they're really their nationals, if they're overstaying. The BI has already canceled visas of many of those who are working were working at the illegal POGO outlets. So work is ongoing right now. No comment. But I know myself. I know. Not it's not only me on trial here. It's my son on trial. It's the country in trial in some ways, but it's par for the course. It happens. And no more comment on that.
Okay.
No. I have. That's the only question that was asked me by the lawyers, no? Who I talked to. And sabi ko, if there is a resolution, do not let it reach the DOJ. Let it be discussed in court, whatever the case may be. If it's an adverse case against my son, it will not be appealed here. It will go straight to the courts for trial.
Sir, balikan ko lang yung kay Percy Lapid. Pasensya ko. Sir, yun nga po, allegedly galing sa loob.
Yes, yes.
Na ito pa dahil siya. Ito po palagi kung narinig na rin yung galit sa loob ng bilibid. Meron po ba tayong mga gagawin na mas talaga nga immediate para po matigilin yung mga ganito na yung mga tao sa loob na nakakulong na? Sino pa pala yung nag-uutos?
Eh, ang problema kasi sa bilibid talaga, kailangan i-uproot na natin talaga eh. Why? Kasi generations and generations of people under the guards of Bilibid feel an entitlement to the positions that they occupy. And that the temptation there is so great that it's so hard to check on these people. A telephone is being sold inside Bilibid for the reports to be at for 300 to 500,000 pesos. That is the extent of how bad it is right now there. Well, you heard about the case where we had the jumpers of 200 houses outside the medium security prison had to be cut off, and that many of the guards are the ones who own it, if not all all of those houses were owned by the guards. We have a big problem in Bilibid. That's why we have to reform our prison system. And not only the transfer of maximum security, but the regionalization of prisons is now on the table. I've discussed this, I've been discussing this within the department and with the DPWH for the past 3 months. The design of the prisons and the financial modeling of the regionalized prisons are being discussed already. And we may even be able to build regional prisons without using the national budget. We have a way of doing it. We have a financial model to do this. We have a financial model to follow.
Sir, last na lang, sir. You mentioned nga yung mga reforms na kailangan pang gawin sa DOJ. So, hindi pa kinamagawang ba na with the rest of your side, it would take all your efforts na
I think that the blessing in this is that people will be more interested to know what we really are doing here for the country. I think that it's something that the country has needed for the longest time. And we were the first ones, not the first ones, we're not reinventing the wheel, but we are the ones who really have the opportunity to do it, because from day one, the president allowed me to organize a team of people who are willing to work for the changes that we are working on. And that is the most important aspect here. Because without a team that you trust, without a team that you believe in, it's very hard to delegate work. And I believe that the people that I brought with me here and the people I selected to work the top on the higher levels, to supervise the lower levels, have been very effective. And we will be continuing to do this, and it will be a legacy-setting administration. And I think that we can be thankful to the president for that. I think that's a human rights issue, but I will not discuss it. Ano to? Ang projection ko kasi, within the next 3 to 4 years, we may be able to build a few regional prisons already. We will work, we will see how it launches within the next 20 months. Because we're just finalizing the design of a regional prison that will be standard throughout the country. And then the financial model will come into play when we speak to the local government units about it. Because it will take a lot of work also, cooperation between the DOJ and the local government units. Can you imagine? Because regionalization solves many problems. No? You're humanizing the prison system. The problem with the prison system now is that it is a mega prison, and it does not bode well for persons who should be treated individually, as is the practice now in prison reform. Right now, everybody is just a number. Out of 39,000 people inside Bilibid, how can you just make sure that everybody is treated properly? So when you humanize it, when you put a prison number limited to 2,500, I think that the reform will be better. Sa una-una pa lang, sa simula pa lang, may dalaw kagad ang tao na nakapiit ay madadalaw na ng kanyang mahal sa buhay. That is the first part of the reformation that a person can get when the time comes.
Sir, ilan yung target natin mapalaya? Kasi sabi natin,
5,000 ang target ko by June 30. That's the target that we have set. The carpetas are coming in more regularly now. I think that the parole and probation office and the Board of Pardon and Parole have more than 2,000 carpetas now already. And it has come faster, at a faster rate than 3 years worth of 3 years worth of carpetas in some areas. But we've done it in just a matter of 100 plus days. In fact, these carpetas were delivered, more than 2,000 carpetas were delivered in the first 100 days of the president. This is very rare in the very rare occurrence in our justice system. I think that you in the justice beat are aware of how slow they were before.
Sir, sorry, kailan po yung inaasahan mass release ulit ng ating mga
PDL? We have pending with the executive secretary 318 names for to be set to liberty either by pardon, parole, and other applications of the law, clemency, pardon, parole, commutation of sentence, acts of grace of the sovereign, as we call it. Ito pa rin, pending pa rin. But finally, I think that something is being done with the new executive secretary at the helm, who we respect all. We all respect the former Chief Justice Lucas Brasabin. I was with him yesterday. I spoke to him yesterday. And a very positive development for us.
Sir, sa illegal bogus, patenta na po.
We will look at the recommendation of the Bureau of Immigration, because somebody in the Bureau has already recommended to me the start of probably a process of amnesty, because this problem has to be resolved for the country. Hindi lang sa Pogo, no? We have so many illegal aliens in this country that have to be recorded properly, and that they are becoming milking cows of many people who should not be doing it. Ano to eh? Ito yung mga nakakaawa talaga na aliens. Some of them are undocumented. Their documents, their visas have already expired. Many of them have been here for years. Some of them from birth. So these illegal aliens, we have to deal with them. It's something that all of this mistreatment of foreigners in our country has to stop. Filipinos are abroad. We all pray that all Filipinos abroad are treated properly. So the foreigners in the Philippines should be accorded to the same humane treatment.
Sir, si Senator Gasalian, meron din po siyang mention na nakaparating po sa kanyang mga reports na ito nga po mga illegal migrant workers ay nabibigitan na raw po, well, nanunuhol na raw para raw po sila ay makapanatili sa bansa. Do you have reports on that?
That's why, sometimes you have to consider all of these suggestions for us. The system was very bad before. If you can imagine that many of these documents were bribe documents. A lot of money was exchanged hands when many of these visas were given before. Let's face it. Let's call a spade a spade. But nagista na natin to rito. Inabutan ko na yan. So what do we do under the circumstances? So we have to look at this from a practical standpoint, as well as, of course, a national standpoint. If there is a national security standpoint, we will speak to the military about it. But we will not ignore any of the important facets of having illegal aliens in our country. But the more important thing, of course, is the fact that there is also international humanitarian law, and you have to be compassionate. After all, what is the DOJ for but to serve compassionate justice? I think that is the very aim here that the president has mentioned to me in the past, no? That it has to be the iron hand with a velvet glove. So we have to be compassionate in our ways, in our thinking. That is the way that society becomes very, you know, very, very civilized and disciplined also at the same time. Anything else? Okay, thank you.